All right. Still sober. I'm John Raven. Thanks for joining me. If you're a sober person, hope you're staying sober. If you're not a sober person, hope you're staying sane. Especially considering the kind of day that we've all had in this area, in this state. Spectrum, aka Time Warner Cable. The internet went out for all of Texas, essentially, which they blamed on damage from the hurricane, which when it hit Texas, it was a tropical storm. So they're blaming it on a tropical storm, which sounds more like a cop-out. You know, it's like everything's held together by noodles, like thin noodles. It's holding everything together. And they're like, it was the storm. The rain and the wind that wasn't even a hurricane that blew through. There was, you know, there was one thin coaxial cable in Shreveport that was holding together all of the internet. And that went down. So, you know, we're going to spend 4 to 6 hours, 7 to 10 hours getting things fixed. Hope it doesn't affect your business at all. Wink. So, a lot of gamers not able to play their games. A lot of influencers having to use their own personal data. Oh, fuck. Cell phone data. Having to use their plan and max it out to make sure that they're still, you know, creating content. Jeez, what a nightmare. Also, a lot of businesses down. I had to pick up flea and tick medicine for my animals and couldn't do it at Petco. Apparently all of Petco was down. Until at the very end of the day, then it was kind of up, but it was up enough that they could actually run the credit card machines. We didn't have online access at work, so it was like, what are we going to do? And I'm like, I guess I'll do fucking busy work, and that's totally did busy work. After 4th of July, I did start eating healthy. And I'm fairly sure I mentioned it last week that I was told that I had high cholesterol, which was a surprise to no one, as I do eat like a college freshman. I do say sentences like, I don't think I ate pizza twice in a day. The thing I ate at lunch was too small to be considered a pizza. It's not necessarily good. So the idea that I'm going to try to bring down my cholesterol level in 2 months for my next appointment, you know, is it a challenge? I don't think it's a challenge. If I just ate like a normal person, like not even cut out red meat completely, just maybe don't eat garbage every day, cut down to garbage once a week, maybe that alone. But I did start eating better, I guess. You know, it's basically cutting out. It's what I'm doing. I'm taking omega fucking 3, the fish oil, and then I'm cutting out red meat for the most part. I'm not going to turn down something yummy, but I'm not going to go pursue it. I'm not going to eat the garbage I eat at lunch, or at least I'm not going to eat the same garbage. I'll probably eat alternate garbage. Like my normal stuff, like adjacent to my normal stuff. Whereas I would eat a pepperoni pizza, maybe I eat a cheese pizza. Maybe instead of the beef burritos, you eat a bean burrito. Is it better for you? Doesn't sound like it. But I'm cutting out red meat. It's what they said. It's like when you eat eggs, only eat egg whites. I'm like, that sounds stupid. Not going to do that. That sounds like something for somebody who eats eggs all the time. But you probably have other things going on. Maybe don't drink that shit like you're Rocky. I don't know what's going on, but yeah, ate healthy. Dealing with this internet thing. I think it's still down. It just kind of worked just enough for me to get my laptop set up to record because I do it through the internet. So I'm going to at least record this. I don't know when I'll be able to upload it. I guess we'll see. When I'm done, we'll see if it, we'll see when you get it. If you get it at the normal time, it was fine. If it shows up late, well, you know why. Just Google Spectrum in your Google News and it'll pull up Spectrum outage and you'll be like, oh wow, John wasn't full of shit. Why would I make that up? I'm not that bored. So I lost my wallet. And that's very, very strange. We don't know what happened. I didn't go anywhere. Like, I walked a block to the vape shop on Friday. That was my last purchase. And then I walked back. Did you drop your wallet on the way back? I don't think so. Pretty sure I would have noticed. But like no activity. There's so many members of the riffraff community that walk around in that area that if I dropped my wallet, one of them would have found it and I don't know, at least attempted to use one of the cards in there, debit card, two credit cards. I had zero activity on any of my cards. Leads me to believe we lost it somewhere in the house, which is really strange because I only put the wallet three places. It's either in my backpack in the same pocket, I've searched all through my backpack, or right next to me, right here at my desk in the one spot that I always put it in, or it's in my pocket. Well, did you check your pants? Yes. I checked my pants. We've done laundry. I've looked all. It doesn't make any sense. And here's the thing. I'm 50 years old. I have never lost a wallet before. Like ever. And that sounds strange because I'm a recovering drug addict and alcoholic. You're like, you never lost your wallet? No. All the years of being blackout drunk, all the years of doing heroin. All the years, the few years I was doing heroin, but all the years that I was blackout drunk, all that combined. And no, I never lost a wallet. And it's quite simple, really. The way I was able to do that is I had a wallet chain. And that is the only reason I never lost my wallet. Wallet chain. It would have been a little hard to do. So, but I no longer have a wallet chain because I started dating a woman who rightfully told me that I should quit wearing it. She didn't tell me to quit wearing it. She said, I believe you should quit wearing that because Jesus Christ, look at your age at the time. You're in your 40s at the time. So, I was like, all right, I guess so. I guess that makes sense. So I quit wearing it. And I'm not saying that it's her fault because honestly, I'd look kind of ridiculous now with my, I mean, I wouldn't look, I still like wallet chains, but I don't know, feel kind of like I don't do the rest of the shit. Like it's just kind of out of place. Like the wallet, I mean, it would, I guess it would work. I still wear Dickies pants and shit. Like, so I could still do it, but no, It's just like, it's like I've kind of aged out of it. It's fine. That's not the point. The point is the wallet's gone. I have no fucking idea where it went. That stinks, because the wallet was a gift from my wife. And that's the biggest problem, is that it was an engraved wallet. But she's like, she said, it can be replaced. And she was like, she goes, I was worried about the fact about your clergy card, because I have a card that signifies that I'm a member of the clergy that I got from the Universal Life Church of Modesto, California. And I have had that card for 20 years. So that is true. I did lose a card that I've had in my possession for 20 years, but it was getting kind of faded. And it's like, oh, it's okay, babe. I can just go online and get another card. It's that easy. The Universal Life Church of Modesto, California will take your money to send you a laminated card with your name on it. You know, and you can get your choice of what to call yourself. Maybe I want to be a bishop this time for some reason. I don't know. Who knows? But I was able to do all my things online, you know, get everything. I froze all the cards first and then kept looking. And then finally was like, I'm not going to find this shit until I actually have to pay for a new license and cancel all my cards and get new ones sent to me. And then only then will I be able to find the wallet just by happenstance. You know, I'll happen upon it probably in a couple of months, and I'll let you know when it shows up. And we'll know who truly is to blame for losing my wallet. All signs are pointing to me, but maybe it was the cat. You know, I don't know. It could definitely be the fucking cat's problem. I got a temporary driver's license. You know, you pay for it, and then it gives you this confirmation on the webpage. It's the confirmation. Here's your confirmation. Here's your information. Print this page out. I'm like, the webpage? Do you have a PDF version of it? Nope. Print this page out. The whole fucking webpage? That's like four pages. It's like, that is this section. And then this is your proof of driver's license for the next 60 days. You know, put this in your car. All four pages of the web page that I printed out. It's like, yes, digital versions of your license will not count. This is the only true valid form of ID. Really? This is a printout of the web page of all text. You don't even have an emblem on the page. You don't even have any kind of weird thing to, like you don't want a digital version because, you know, photos can be altered. Well, what about the fucking text confirmation that I have? Dude, I could fake this shit with WordPerfect in 1997. This is my proof. All right. Fucking idiots. Goddamn state government and local government. It's just all backwards. It's like, can't you update a little bit? It's fucking crazy. You know what also is crazy? Is the way people are driving. I do not understand. Like, the inconsistency is what I don't get. I don't understand how people drive like they're in their 20s on straightaways. They drive like goddamn madmen. Like super fast on straightaways, right? And maybe even little curves. But when they turn left or turn right, all of a sudden they become 80 years old. And they have to slow real down and just, like, like oversized wheel turn, just da 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 turning left. It's even or you know, turning right, but real slow. I don't want to tip over in my Subaru. You're not gonna fucking tip over in your goddamn Subaru wagon. You can drive. You don't have to. You don't have to. You don't have to turn at 5 miles an hour when you were just driving 50. It's insane. It slows everybody down, and everybody does it. It's weird. I saw a fucking SUV also do this thing where they were going to turn left, and they kind of like looked like they were pulling over, like they had to swing right so that they could take an even bigger left. I'm like, God damn, man. It's a 4Runner. It's built to do this shit. It's a 4Runner. I'm like, well, I don't know if it's made to turn left. It's a fucking car. That's all you do is turn left or right. It's like half of your turns. Jesus, man. What are we doing? Anyway, I have no real point today. Other than I'm guessing about half of the people who listen to me live in Texas. You would think it'd be all, but it's actually demographics wise. Like I get the IP information. It's about half. So I think most of my core audience is like people who know me or a friend of a friend kind of a thing. So it's all like Texas, but I've kind of branched off into randos from across the country and across the world. And, oddly enough, and you know, I'm big in Australia, apparently. What was the other country? All right, I'm looking at Ireland. I am big in Australia and Ireland. A little bit the UK, but it's basically that's yeah, it's like last week was almost like 10 to 15% of my downloads came from Ireland, which is interesting. It's like, thanks. Appreciate it. Anyway, if you find yourself in a situation where your internet is down, and I hope you're not listening to me from a country who's like, our internet is rarely up. And then I'm like, well, I'm really sorry that I just did a first world problem on you. Like, hey, if you could even imagine what it's like to go out with the internet, you know, not having the internet on your laptop for, you know, half a day. I know it's hard to imagine. I don't know. It'd be interesting to know how you made use of that. If you argued online on your phone, if you just stared at your phone going, well, I guess I'll watch YouTube on my phone and use all my data, or if you took that time to actually do other things, like what my wife decided to do. She decided to clean a bunch of shit that she'd put off doing. She's like, nah, I'm gonna do that now. And I'm like, all right. Why? It's a fucking Tuesday. It's like, whatever. I've talked about it. It's because if the internet's down, you can't have Trash Tuesday. And that's what my wife likes to do. They like to watch fucking MILF Manor, which apparently they still have Trash Tuesday, but like it aired live on TLC on Sunday night. So she actually went to a friend's and watched it live. They actually watched the show. Is so bad and yet so appealingly bad that my wife watched live fucking TV. That's amazing to me, but that's what she did. So, but now she's cleaning. So I don't know. I'm hoping that you take the time to do something with friends or with family. If you get a break from the internet, just, you know, or play a video game that's offline. I don't fucking care. I don't know. Just use it to do something that that makes you feel like you don't have yet another addiction, you know, to internet shit, which you probably do, much like we all do. But hopefully it's one, it's an easier one to kick than, say, heroin or anything like that. So I don't have anything else. I just needed to bitch about the fact that I lost my fucking wallet. That still blows my mind. I don't know. I almost don't even care about getting the wallet back. I do care, but like I just want closure. And not even so much closure, like, oh, like I just want to know what happened. No, I just want to know what happened. Where the fuck was it? Did I drop it? Sure, maybe I dropped it. But I was completely sober and paying attention. And that's weird to drop your wallet while you're walking, while paying, like with complete awareness and not fucked up. Isn't it weird? I think it's weird. It's fine. StillSoberPod@gmail.com for any questions or comments that are positive to neutral. Like I said, shout out Ireland. Shout out Australia. Thank you, guys. And shout out USA. We just celebrated, you know, another, you know, year of our country's birthday. Woohoo! We'll see what happens this year. Anyway, we'll see you next week. All right. Later. Fight for the fiercest skin. Come back down to earth again. The coldest creep, the deep inside. Disconnect the telephone line.